Well, hello, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back. Jiu-Jitsu 2000 here today. I'm back. I hope you guys are doing fantastic. I've got an interesting video for you today. We're going to talk about the X-Star Model SP100. This is a 100-watt foldable solar panel. I'm very excited about this review. Where there is sunshine, there is power. Laid upward, it's fragile, keep away from moisture. Laid flatwise, recyclable, and three layers. So on the side of the packaging, you don't see nothing there. And then of course, on the back, here is some of the information about this. I'm gonna read this. Peak power, 100 watts. Cell efficiency of 23%. Working voltage is 17.6 volts. Working current, 6.25 amps. That's pretty impressive. Open circuit voltage of 23.76 volts. Short circuit current, 7.5 amps. Operating temperature is anywhere from minus 10 to 65 degrees centigrade. Folded size is 620 millimeters by 536 millimeters by 30 millimeters. And the unfolded size, 1236 millimeters by 536 millimeters by 15 millimeters. Now the net weight is 4.4 kilograms and you have the solar panel and a manual in here. So some of the features, foldable solar panel, weighs 4.4 kilograms, easy to carry. Sun power silicone wafer offers up to 23% cell efficiency, longer lifespan, patented kickstand with three adjustable angles available. Very cool. Now the exquisite foldable solar panel has cell efficiency up to 23%. So they must be very proud about that because they say that in three different places. Was created to harvest the sun power and save your electricity bill. Its surface is covered by ETFE. That's fantastic film, which features high corrosion resistance and has strength over wide temperature range. Furthermore, it provides you three adjustable angles with X-Star's patented kickstand, weighs 4.4 kilograms only, very convenient to carry outdoors. So without further ado, let me take this little ninja star here and open this bad boy up with this shuriken here. So let's open the package, pull it out, and see, is there anything left in the box there? I do not see anything left in the box. So it looks like we have everything that we need right here. As you can see, it comes packaged very well. Very well. It's in bubble wrap there, so very cool. We're going to go ahead and pull this out. I'm telling you right now, my first thought is this thing feels pretty durable. Here's a look at the owner's manual. Feel free to pause your screen if you want to hang on to anything in this owner's manual. So it's like a trifold. Right here are some of the technical parameters on the solar panel. Here are some tips. Let me close that in the back so you don't get that light through the back there. And of course, like it shows on that second page, it shows about how you can stand it up. So that information looks pretty good. It's a nice little simple owner's manual there. Now the first thing I'm going to take a look at is this leg. Wow, that's pretty cool. So you have a Velcro enclosure down here, and it looks like you have adjustable bungees here. That is pretty cool. So there's another one on this side, same type of deal. Very cool, I like the way they did that. Now I wanna take a minute and show you these legs a little bit closer. These are fantastic. You can see that there's like this little buckle area right here. So you can bring this down and leave the legs at that position, or you can drag it out a little more and you get it about where you want it, and then it's gonna stay put right there. Now this upper section from here up, that's all flexible up there. This is very well thought out. Again, you just put that whatever size you need and the panel would sit just like that. Now this is an epoxy table, so it's gonna slip and slide here, but if you had some real ground out there, you can adjust these to just about whatever you want. I really like the way they did the legs on this thing. So you can get multiple angles out of these legs to get the best solar input that this panel will provide. I can tell that the zipper is like water resistant and a long cord with an 8mm output. So this is very, very cool. This is gonna fit most of your solar generators that run on that 8mm port. I like that because they get right to the point. It would have been nice if there would have been like a USB or something here too. That would have been pretty cool. So opening it up, this is magnetic. These magnets right here stick together. That is a beautiful panel. Those cells look very much like my Renogy 100 watt flex panel. Those are fantastic. I also noticed that up here on the corners, there's these grommets right here where you could tie this thing off. So if you wanted to hang this, maybe on the side of your building or something like that, where you're gonna get sun from the south, you can hang that right there. Very, very cool. It looks very nice. It looks like it's built really well. I love the fact that it's got the 8mm right on it. And this cord appears to be long enough so you could set the solar out in the sun and run this cable far enough away where your power generator can be in the shade. So let me see about how long this is. There's one arm length. So that's about almost two arm lengths. So that's probably 10 feet, I'm guessing. 8 to 10 feet of cord here. Got the sun coming from that angle. Oh yeah, that's really effective. I like that. I am bringing in 60 watts of charge input right now. 106. 112. Wow. 112 watts. Holy smokes, that's fantastic. I am very impressed with these numbers. Look at this. It's a 100 watt panel and I'm bringing in 111 watts of solar input. That is just fantastic. And that's what it looks like. I've got it aimed directly at the sun. And that ETFE, those panels, if it gets a little bit of moisture on it, it's not gonna hurt that. That's water resistant. There's a look at the back. I am impressed with the performance of this panel. It's performing higher than what it's rated at. Let's plug it into this Blue Eddy and see what happens here with the Blue Eddy. So there you can see the charging has begun and we are bringing in 85 watts on the Blue Eddy. That's fantastic, folks. That is very, very good performance. That's gonna charge these units very quickly. Okay, just for fun and for the sake of testing, I put my 100 watt Renogy flexible panel, laid it right on top. I've got the MC4 connectors to this 8mm. And I'm gonna plug this into the X-Star and let's see what my Renogy panel does. What kind of wattage is my Renogy panel bringing in? 91, 90. So as you can see, the X-Star 100 watt SP100 brings in just as much, if not more, than my Renogy. See what kind of numbers the Renogy brings us. It takes a second, just like the other one did. 60. So we were getting more wattage input out of the SP100 than we are currently getting out of the Renogy 100 watt flex panel. We cannot go into this small Blue Eddy because the max wattage input for this one is 60 watts. So we're gonna plug into this OOPS and see what it does. 73 watts of input, which makes me wonder. Let me plug in the SP100. We're gonna move the Renogy out of the way. Let's move it out of the way, set it back over here. We'll give that SP100 a little bit of time. This is the cable from it. Plug that bad boy in. And let's see what kind of numbers we develop. There we go. Look at that. It just took it a little time. Look at that. Now we're up in the 90s. I saw it hit 92 a second ago. Check that out. So we are bringing in 90 watts. Push that again. There we go. 89 watts. It just took it a little longer. That's all. Just had to be patient with it. But that is fantastic. That is the SP100 bringing that power in right there. 89 watts. Fantastic. 93. That is very acceptable power input. I'm impressed with this panel. All right, let's take a look at what we got going on here. I've got kind of a cool little thing here going on. So starting off with the camera that we are filming with. So that is the top cord that you see right here. The bottom cord is this Makita battery charger, currently charging a 18 volt lithium ion battery. I have the X-Star battery charger that has 8 bays, and it's charging 8 batteries simultaneously. Over here in the back, I have my GoPro charging. And then over here, we have 4 different Olight flashlights charging simultaneously. These two are 21700 batteries, and these two are 18650 batteries. As you can see, this one here is charged. So the numbers that we're looking at are extremely impressive. We're pulling 238 watts of output and bringing in around 100 input. And this is quite a test to run off of this, not only the power station, but the solar panel. So we've got the X-Star solar generator, we've got the X-Star VC8 battery charger, and again, the SP100 X-Star solar panel. All of this stuff is working absolutely fantastic. This is a fun test, and I am impressed with how all of this stuff is working. Let's not forget that we have DC 12 volt outputs here still available. We're just not using them right now. Remember earlier in the video when I first opened up the solar panel and I said, I wish this panel had some USB connectivity on it? Well, X-Star had thought about that. They released this device called the EU4S. And what this does, in the event that you don't have a solar generator, you can use this to bridge the gap and get USB power off of your solar panel. They also offer a couple accessories. This is a 8mm to 8mm. It's a male and female. It's basically just an extension cord. This is 10 feet long. You can pick that up. They also have a couple little adapters that will plug into the 8mm here. You have a little bit more connectivity options. And then in the event that you want to use this solar panel as a standard solar panel, they do offer an 8mm to MC4 connector. So you can use this for off-grid applications. Now here's a look at the back of the packaging. So please feel free to pause your screen if you want to read any of this information. I think this is absolutely fantastic because, like I mentioned earlier, this device bridges the gap between the solar panel and charging your devices without having to purchase a solar generator. Now, I still think that a solar generator is the best option, but this is pretty cool too. So let's go ahead and open the package and we'll see what's included. So here's a quick look at this little owner's manual. Let's go to English. There's the introduction to it. There's all the specifications. Here's how you operate the device. And the anti-fake and a warning. And then of course there is the information for X-Star in the event that you might want to reach out to them. The next thing that we see is a 12 volt car outlet, so you can plug this into your car. I like that it has the little red indicator, so it'll light up when this thing is live, and it's got an 8mm on the other side. So this is cool because you can use this cord to charge your solar generator, or you can also use it to plug into this device here. It plugs in right in the back, and then this thing comes to life. You've got a quick charge USB port right there on the top. You have two standard 2.4 amp ports, and then you have a USB-C port there on the bottom. And then on the side, you have a little LCD display and a button. So when I have the cord off of the panel, that gives me 10 feet. And then when I add this, it gives me an additional 10 feet. So I'm gonna run this cord up onto the desk. Okay, so this is the cord coming in from outside. We're gonna plug this in. Using the power off of the solar basically bypasses the need for a solar generator. The cool thing about the solar generator is when you have intermittent sunlight, you can store power here, and then when the sun comes out, you can charge this. This only works if you have sun, but I think it's super cool. We're still charging the GoPro. We still have 8 batteries simultaneously charging. We have 4 flashlights charging. This one's already finished. And then again, you can cycle through the modes and look at what it's doing. I have one more port available of USB-C. I'm not using that one right now, but it's so cool that X-Star thought of that, and it bridges the gap from the solar panel to USB devices. And this is a lot of stuff to be running at once. Very impressive. So there's a look at the solar panel. There's the wire, comes right on up, right on into the device. And right there, you can see the screen. Again, you can cycle through and look at each USB and see what each one's doing. There's the first one, 5 volts, 0.9 amps. There's the second one, 1.6 amps. Third one, 0.7, and type C we're not using. So that's pretty cool. It powers all of these things. We're charging 4 different flashlights, 8 different batteries simultaneously, and you see the little red indicator of the GoPro. So that is really, really cool. Another cool thing about the extension cord is if you needed to park your power station in the shade, you can power this device from your car. So you put that and that in there, close that up, and you have a complete solar kit that has everything you need anywhere you go. You can put those MC4s in there too, and these little adapters. Very cool, the amount of things that this panel can do. I think it's absolutely fantastic. Well folks, my final thoughts on this SP100 solar panel are, it is fantastic. Fantastic, I think, would be an understatement. This thing performs better than I expected. It just blew me away. When I work with my Renogy flexible 100 watt panel, I always get that feeling that I'm gonna tweak it, or I'm gonna crack it, or it's fragile, you know. This one, I never got that feeling when I worked with it. It's constructed very well. It's housed in this material. The legs work fantastic. They deploy very easily. They put away very easily. And as you saw in the video, the performance speaks for itself. I hope that you're checking the description box down below, because I will put links to where you can find this solar panel SP100 by X-Star. This thing is like I said, it's fantastic. These solar generators work very well. Also, I'll put links to them as well in the description. These are the same exact model, just different colors. But these work very well. They power tons of things around the house. If you haven't seen my video review of them, please make sure that you check the description, because I'll put links to that, to those videos as well. But this thing is an A+ from me. I'm just blown away. So folks, I want to say thank you for joining me today on this video. I hope you got some good useful information out of it. As always, please feel free to leave comments down below, like this video, share this video, and until next time, have a beautiful day. We'll see you then. Bye for now.